Let's look at network in graph theory. So in this chapter, you will see a lot of graph, but this graph is different from what you have learned last time, like the bar chart, line graph. Okay, this graph consists of a series of vertices and also edges. This is an example of a graph. We have the vertex A, vertex B, vertex C, vertex D, and vertex E. Plural, we call it vertices. Okay, if we want to write down all the vertices, we can represent it by using set notation. V stands for vertices. So we have A, B, C, D, and E. A, B, C, D, and E. Number of vertices is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5. Okay, edges. So we have E1, E2, E3. Since the graph already labeled with this E1, E2, E3, so we can write this way: E1, E2, E3, E3, E4, E5, and E6. Okay, we can write this way. But sometimes the edges is not labeled by this E1, E2, E3 like this. So how do you write the edges? You can do it this way as well. This edge connecting A and C, right? So you can put a parenthesis here, parenthesis, then write AC. Then people know that there's an edge connect A and C. This is undirected graph, means that you don't have directions here. You can go this way or this way, two way. We don't have arrow here, so you can write AC or CA. It's the same thing. Okay, now AB. And then we have BC, CE, CD, and the last one is BD. Okay, so let me double check again, correct or not. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, correct. Number of edges is equal to 6. Okay, so this is the way how we write the vertices and also the edges. This part I think is not very important for you. This connected graph and connected graph. So what is a connected graph? A graph is said to be connected if there is a path between each pair of vertices. Okay, let me label first A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. So this is just extra information. Means that there's always a path between two vertices. For example, is that possible for you to go from A to F? Yes. You can go this way, right? Go this way, go this way, go this way. So is that possible for you to go from B to E? Yes. You can go this way, this way. Okay, that's always exists a path between two vertices. Some graph is disconnected, are disconnected. For example, let me give an example. Let's say I have a graph here, A, B, and C. Okay, this is E, F, G. Okay, now I have a graph. The vertices is A, B, C, D. Oh, let me label this one as E and F. A, B, C, D, E, and F. Okay, I have a graph here, but this graph is said to be disconnected. Disconnected. Why? Okay, now you try to think, is that possible for you to travel from A to D? No, we have no path to go from A to D. How about A to F? How about B to F? We are not able to do that, right? So this is disconnected graph. So this graph is very obvious. When you look at it, you know this is disconnected graph. But some disconnected graph is not so obvious. For example, let me give you, let me draw a graph for you. You have a graph like this. Okay, let's say this is A, this is B, this is C, D, E, and F. Is this a connected graph? No, this is actually not a connected graph. Okay, try to think, is that possible for you to travel from A to D? Is there a path for you to travel from A to D? Okay, you might think this way. Okay, I can go start from here, go here, then go here, right? No. We cannot do this way because the HDE and the HAC, they actually do not meet each other. Because here we don't have a point, we don't have a vertex here. If we have a vertex here, that means DE meets AE at this point, then you can travel from here, go here, then go here, right? Okay. But since now, we don't have a vertex here, it means that DE, you try to think this way, DE is a bridge on the top and AC is a bridge underneath DE, pass through underneath DE. So they actually do not meet each other. So you are not able to travel from A to E, A to D, A to E. So this is actually a disconnected graph. So A can go to B, can go to C, but it's not able to go to E, D, and F. So this is a disconnected graph. But I think this is not very important for you, but just some extra information. Okay, so now look at this. We have an H, we have a loop like this. Just now, this graph is a simple graph because we don't have any H, we don't have a loop, we don't have multiple H's. That is called simple graph. And this is not a simple graph because you have a loop. You have a loop. So this one we call it as a loop. So when you have a loop, how do you write the edge for a loop? Vertex, vertices, no problem, right? A, B, C. Just like just now what we did. A, B, and C. So when we go to edges. So this is A, B, A, C. And then we have BC. Okay, how to write this H? This you can think this way, come out from B, go back to B, right? BB. When you see the edges, same vertex means that B to B or C to C, D, D, A, A. That means that this H is a loop. Okay, this is multiple edges that I mentioned just now. When the graph have a multiple edges or loop, then it's not a simple graph. Simple graph does not have a multiple edges or loop. Okay, so same thing if you want to write all the vertices using set A, B, C. And the edges, so we have AB, we have AC, AB, and then AC. Okay, these two edges connecting, these two red color one, connecting B and C, right? So we need to write two times. B, C, B, C. When you see, when you are given the edges and you see two things exactly the same, that means there is a multiple edges between this vertex B and vertex C. Okay, this I told you just now, simple graph, it's a graph with no loop, no multiple edges, and this all this You have multiple edges and loop. That's not a simple graph. Okay, now let's look at this one. How do we state the degree of vertex? Here we have A, B, C, D, E, F. What is this? A, B, C, D, E, and F. So the number of vertices is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6. Okay, so let me write edges first. Edges. So we have AB, AD, AC. AB, AD, AC. Okay. Then we have BE, BD. BE, BD. Okay, how to write this edge? Loop. Right, so it's BB. BB. Okay, then we have CD, CD, multiple edges. CD. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, let me double check again. So F here, we don't have any edge connect to F, so this vertex we call it as isolated vertex. Okay, let me double check, is that correct? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so correct. Now, how do we write the degree? You will see all the degree of every vertex is it's already written here, but how do I get this number 3, 5, 3, 4, 1, and 0? Okay, it's actually very easy. You just calculate how many edge go to that point, go to that vertex. Okay, this we call vertex. Sometimes you see some book, they will use node. It's the same thing. Okay, now we go for A first. Now we look at A. Okay, I use this A. Degree of vertex A. So you just count this way. 1. 2, 3. So some students they like to cut like this. 1, 2, 3. It's all up to you as long as you can get the degree of that vertex. 3. Okay, how about B? So you have 1, oh, 1, 2, oh, what happened? 1, 2, 1, 2, okay, 1, 2. And loop contribute 2 degrees. 3, 4. So a loop considered as one edge, right? But when we calculate degree, it's contribute 2 degree. Okay, remember 1, 2, 3, 4. I missed up this one. I have another one which is 5. Okay, let me calculate again. Let me show you again how to get 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay. Let me go to C. 1, 2, 3. Okay, then we go to D. So 1, 2, this one we have to count one more time. You cannot say just now already counted, then I don't have to calculate again. You still need to calculate as 1 degree. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have 4. And go to the last one, or not last one. Second last. E. So you have 1. And then go to F. Don't have any H connect to this F, so it's 0. So you try to find the sum of degree. Sum of degree means all this degree plus together. So you will get 16, right? 16. 3 plus 5 plus 3 plus 4 plus 1 will give you 60. Actually, we have another way to help us to get the sum of degree. So this is the formula that we use. Sum of degree is equal to 2 times the number of ages. 2 times the number of ages. So number of ages is 8 here. So it means 2 times 8, which will give you 16. Exactly the same thing. Okay, so from here we know that because you have a 2 here, whatever you multiply by 2, the number that you get must be an even number, right? So we know that the sum of degree for any graph will always be an even number. Okay, you see my note here, the sum of degree is always even. Okay, a loop contributes 2 degree to the vertex and it's counted as one age. Okay, let's say for example this one. Oh, this is just same thing like this, so I think it should be should be no problem. Okay, let's proceed to this example number one. Draw a graph to represent the network of bridges in the above diagram. Okay, let me label the regions as A, B, C, and D. Okay, we need to draw a graph to represent this network. So the region, we can represent them by drawing a vertex A, B, C, and D. Okay, the next thing is to draw an edge to represent to draw the edges to represent all the bridges here. So we have two bridges connecting A and B, right? Oh, let me label first. A, B. A, B. C and D. Okay, so we have two bridges connecting region A and B. Okay, I just draw this way. Multiple edges. Okay, B and C, same thing. Two bridges. Okay, so B to D, one bridge only, so I draw one line, one edge. Okay, then this is A to D. A to D, we have another line, another edge here, and then C to D. Okay, C to D. Okay, this is a graph that we can use to represent this network. And this is not a simple graph because you have multiple edges. Okay, so we want to state the degree of each vertex of this graph. Okay, let's try degree for vertex A. 1, 2, 3. So we have 3, the degree is 3. Oh, okay, let me draw it again. Then degree for vertex B, degree for vertex B. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5. Degree of vertex C. One, two, three. Okay, it's 3. And degree for the last vertex, which is D. One, two, three. Okay, 3. So let's find the question just asked to state the degree for each vertex. But why not we try to find the sum of degree. Sum of degree for all the vertices. It means 3 plus 5 plus 3 plus 3. 14. 14, right? Okay. So besides calculating this way to get the sum of degree, we also can use that formula. Still remember what I told you just now, that formula. sum of degree is equal to 2 times the number of ages. So 2 times the number of ages, how many ages we have? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 14. You get the same answers. Okay? Okay, let's try example 2. For each of the following graph, determine the number of vertex, the number of vertices, number of ages, and the sum of degree. Okay, so this one, I think I just show you B. If you know B, to solve B, you should be no problem to get A. Okay, now you have a point which don't have any ages connecting to this point and this vertex 6, we call it isolated vertex. Okay, so let me write all the vertices first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, the number of vertices will be 1, 2, okay, 6. Now we go to age. Okay, let me write down all the ages first. 1, 5, 1, 2. We have 1, 5, 1, 2, and then 5, 2. 5, 2, you can write 2, 5, the same thing, because this is undirected graph. 2, 3, 2, 4. 2, 3, 2, 4. Okay, great. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Number of ages is equal to 5. Let me double check again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, correct. Sum of degree. Okay, so if you remember that formula, sum of degree is equal to 2 times the number of ages, then I know that the sum of degree must be equal to 2 times number of ages, which is equal to 5, 10. The sum of, this one I forget to write the sum of degree. Okay. The sum of degree for any graph will always be an even number. Okay, so let's double check, see whether correct or not. The degree here is 1, 2. The degree here is 1, 2. The degree here is 1, 2, 3, 4. The degree here is 1. And the degree here is 1. Okay, this is 0. Okay, then we take 2 plus 2, 4. 4 plus 4 will give you 8, plus 1, 9, 9 plus 1, 10. Same thing. Okay? Okay, this one. Let's try B. It's almost the same thing like what we did just now. Vertex. All we write down all the vertices A, B, C, D, E. A, B, C, D, and E. And then number of vertices 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And ages, okay, I think I write over here. So we have loop AA. AA. Okay. And you have A, B, A, C. A, B. I think I write over here because. Okay, it should be no problem. A, B. And A, C. A, C. Okay, then we have B, C. B, C. Multiple ages. B, C. We have to write two times because there are two ages here. B, C, B, C. And then we have BE, BE, another multiple ages, BE, BE. Okay, then we have DE, and the last one is CD. So number of ages is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, let me double check again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, correct. Number of ages is equal to 9. So how about the degree? So this means you have to state the degree for every vertex. Okay, I think I write over here. Is that okay? Okay, okay. Here don't have. Please, okay. I just write here a vertex for A. So be careful when you see a loop. Remember, a loop contributes 2 degrees to that vertex. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So how about B? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, then we go to C. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we go to D. 1, 2. And the last one is E. 1, 2, 3. Okay, let's try find sum of the degree. 9, 10, 11, 12, 18. Okay, so if we try to use that formula to check, sum of degree is equal to 2 times the number of ages. Sum of degree is equal to 2 times the number of ages. See whether we get same answer or not. Yes, correct. Same answer, 18. Okay, let's look at this example. I will just show you B. Okay, I show you A. So we have draw a simple graph. Means that the graph does not contain any multiple ages or loop. We only want a simple graph. So there are a few ways to draw this graph. Some students, they like to, for example, they like to draw the ages first. P, okay, they start P, then connected to R and connecting to S. So P connecting to R, connecting to S, and then Q connecting to R and T. R and T. And then R to S. S T. Okay. So let me check around 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so this is the way how we draw the graph. When we are given all the ages here, it's very easy for us to draw the graph. So some students, they don't want to draw it this way. First, they just draw all the vertices here first. P, Q, R, S, T. P, Q, R, S, T. And then only they start to connect the point like P, R. Okay, P go to R. Then P, S. P go to S. Q, R. Q go to R. Q, R is, this is undirected graph. It can Q go to R or R go to Q. Because Q, T. Okay. And then R, S. S, T. Okay, you might feel that these two different, right? So which one is correct? These two are correct. So, and remember, the QT do not have any intersection between the QT does not meet PS and PR. PR and PS on the top, and QT underneath this PR and PS. If you don't like to see any like these intersections, but this is actually not an intersection. You can change the shape. After you draw this, you can change the shape of the graph. Okay, maybe you want to modify the graph, make it look nicer. If you feel that this is not nice, look a little bit messy, you want to change it, it's okay, you can do it this way. So this is Q, this is T, this is S, this is R. Okay, then connect all this together. And then this point, this vertex, you just bring it over here. P. Okay. Let me check it or not. PR. So we have, okay, let me use another card. PR. Yes, we have PR. PS. Yes. QR. Yes. QT. Yes. RS. Yes. And ST. Yes. Okay. And remember, don't give this answer. You have to don't. You have to erase all this line. This is the final answer. You can give this one or this one or this one. All these are considered correct answer. Okay. Now we look at this. This might be a little bit complicated. Only the degrees of all the vertices are given to you, but we don't know which edge connect to which edge. So you will have a few methods to solve this type of question. You can try and error, guess. Okay, let me show you that few method that I mentioned just now. Okay, determine whether a graph with the following degrees of vertices can be drawn. If it can be drawn, then we have to draw it. We have to draw the graph. Okay, we look at A. We find the sum of degree. That's what I told you. Sum of degree will be always equal to an even number. So 4 plus 2 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. So the sum of degree here is 12. How about this? Sum of degree. This is 11. So B, the graph cannot be drawn because this is not an even number. Okay, A, it can be drawn. So now we are going to draw this graph. So there are a few methods. Some students, they just like to draw all this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, you can just simply draw 5 vertices. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then you see 1. Okay, you just connect. Okay, this point center. Because we want 1 degree only. So we cannot add any other edges connect to this point anymore. So we have 4 here. So we can add 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay, now the total degree for this vertex will be 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, this done. Okay, so we need 2, 3, 2. So how about I connect 1 point here, then this become 2, done. And then, okay, I connect this 1. Okay, this is 3, yes, done. And this one, last one is 2, correct. Correct or not? Let me check. Okay, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3, last one, 1, 2, okay. 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, okay, correct. This is a graph, right, that we are looking for. So some students, they don't want to do this way. You can do it this way as well. Okay, I just let the set be the sequence degree. S be the degree sequence. So 1, 4, 2, 3, 2. Okay. Then I just label it by A, B, C, D, and E. Okay, so now I try to remove, let's say if you have a graph. Okay, let me draw the graph for you first. Okay, so copy first. 1, 4, 2, 3, 2. So I just let be A, vertex, this vertex A, B, C, D, E. Okay, so I try to reduce the degree here. So if I remove point B, let's say this is point B, the degree is 4. If I remove the point B, all the degree for other vertices will minus 1, right? The degree is minus 1. The degree here will minus 1. The degree here also will minus 1 because no more edges, no more this edge. And the degree here, if I cancel the point, I remove this point, no more this all edges. So the degree for every single vertex here will minus 1. So now I going to remove this. So okay, you can draw the line if you want. Okay, here minus 1. Here minus 1, here minus 1, here minus 1. Now, no more b, we have removed the point, the vertex b. And here becomes 0 degree. And this becomes 1. And the degree for this is 2. And the degree for this is 1. Okay. Now, okay, this let's be S1. This just an alphabet, you can use as these up to you. Okay, now I remove D. So I assume that D is connecting to C and D. So here I have to minus 1, here I have to minus 1. Now this is 0. Okay, let me use the same color. This is 0. So this one, just copy. And this becomes 0C. And this becomes no more. We have removed the D, the vertex D. And this becomes 0E. Okay, then we like going backwards. We draw the vertex, the vertices with 0 degree. Means that now they are isolated. So I just draw A, C, and E. A, C, and E. Okay, now I try and go backward like this. So you notice that here I add a D. When I add the vertex D, the D is connecting to C and E. Okay, I add a D here. D here. So this D is connecting to C and E. Okay, then go backward further. I add a B, and the B is connecting to A, C, D, and E. Okay, I just add a B here. B. And B is connecting to A, to C, to D, to E. Okay, let's double check whether the answer is correct or not. Huh? So this is degrees 1, this 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, and this 3, and then this degree 2. 1, 4, 2, 3, 2. 1, 4. Okay, correct. So you can draw it this way as well. You can use this method. And some students, they have another method, which I'm going to show you here. If you don't want to use this method, another method is like this. Okay, the beginning step is just like same like just now. And let this vertex be A, B, C, D, E. For some, they like to arrange. If you don't want to arrange, it's okay. So if you want to arrange, okay, let's be S, this S1, S1 prime. You want to arrange all the vertex, all the vertices from the big degree to from the bigger degree to the smaller degree. You can. If you don't want to arrange, it's okay. To C, to E, and then 1A. Okay, so now I just simply draw A, B, C, D, E. Draw this few points. A, B, C, D, E. Okay, A, B, C, D, E. Okay, now I'm going to remove this B. No more B, and minus 1 here, 1 here, 1 here, and 1 here, right? Because this B is connecting to this, 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 and this. So, okay, now I start to draw. B connecting to D, B connecting to C, B connecting to E, and then B connecting to A. Now here it becomes, you have to minus 1, the degree, or you have to minus 1, 2D. Okay, this 1, see, this 0. Okay, now I remove the point D. And the D is connecting to C and E. Become S3. Okay, now no more D. And the D is connecting to C and E, right? Okay. D is connecting to C and E. Okay. So this is 0, C, 0. Oh. Zero A O, granite. Okay, so correct. So let me check again. 1, 4, 2, 3, 2. Okay, so this is another way to draw this graph. If you feel that this method is very complicated, you feel it's very hard for you, you don't use this method. You just use like guessing. And try to try and error until you get the answers. If you don't have time, you can actually skip these type of questions, go to other questions first. When you have time, just go back to solve these type of questions. Because sometimes try and error, sometimes if you are lucky, very fast to get the answers. Sometimes it's a little bit unlucky, you might take a longer time to get the answers. Okay, let's try example number 6. So this type of questions will be easier compared with example number 5, because example number 6, the ages all are given to you, so it's pretty straightforward. You don't have to guess. Okay, let me label A, B, C, D, E. Okay, same thing. If you want to draw the ages first, then keep on adding the vertex, keep on adding the vertices, or you want to draw the vertices first, it's all up to you. A, B, C, D, E, A, B, C, D, E, A to B, A to B, A to C, A to C, two same thing, multiple ages, A to C and A to C, then A to D, A to D, okay. B to C, C to D, D D, oh, this is a loop, and then D E. Okay, then this is the final answer. State the sum of degree. So why the sum of degree? I think we just use formula. It's 2 times the number of ages. So 2 times how many ages we have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2 times 8, which is equal to 16. Granted, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so the sum of degree is equal to 16. Okay, let's try last one. Last example for this video. Okay, so this I think I just showed you 1, 4, 4, 3. 1443. So same thing, you want to try and error, guess also can. If you don't want, you like to use a method I show you, it's all up to you, as long as you can get a graph with all this stated degree. Okay, I just let S be 1, 4 as a degree sequence. You can use other alphabet like D, A, B, C, it's all up to you. Okay, 4, 3. Okay, so then I label A, B, C, D. Okay, so I try to reduce the degree for every vertex. So let's say if you have a multiple ages, I did for example A, B, right? If you remove the point A, the vertex A, you need to minus not 1 degree, 2 degree, because this is multiple ages. So the degree for B, for vertex B, you need to minus 2. And let's say if you have a loop here, you remove it, you have to minus a degree 2 from the vertex A. Okay, so there are few answers for these questions, as long as the graph that you draw fulfill all this degree stated here. Okay, let me do it this way. S1. Okay, now I'm trying to remove, I think about multiple ages first. So the multiple edges must be connecting to B or C, because you know that if there are only three, four, what is this? If here connect to here, connect to here, connect to here, maximum you get three only. It's not possible for you to get four. There must be a loop or multiple edges. Okay, so I assume that the multiple edges is between C and D. So I minus 2 and minus 2. Here I have a multiple edges. Same thing, you want to reduce the degree first, then you go backward and draw the graph, or you want to draw the graph. For example, if you want to draw first, A, B, C, D, okay. Some they like to draw first, it's okay. Okay, C and D. So they draw, then minus, then keep on reduce the degree. You feel that this method, because some students they don't like use this method because maybe they feel complicated. If you feel that it's not suitable to you, don't use it, just use guessing. Okay, now okay, so here become 1A, so this is still the same for B. Now I have 2C, here I have 1D. So now I know that, I guess, there's a loop, here also guessing actually, that there's a multiple edges between C and D. Now I think about loop, because I want multiple edges and loop. This is not a simple graph. Okay, so I remove 2 degree from here. I assume that the loop is over here. So now I have a loop. So this is 1A. So now this is 2B. So this is 2C and this is 1D. Okay, S trade. So I remove the B. I remove this vertex B. So I assume that the vertex B is connecting to C and D. No more vertex B. And this has become minus 1. Minus 1 become 1C. And this is 0D. Okay, so the last H is A and C. I remove a point A. Remove the vertex A. And no more B, and this becomes 0 and 0. Okay, now we work backward. We draw these 2 points first, C and D. Okay, C and D. Then if I go backward here, I add 1 point, which is A, and the A is connecting to C, right? A is connecting to C. This C. Okay, let me check correct, not C, D, okay. A is connecting to C, yes, okay. So now I'm going to add B. And the B is connecting to C and D. And D. And then go backward, I have a loop here, B. And multiple edges between C and D. Okay, let me double check again, see whether this answer correct or not. The degree is 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 1, 2, 3, oh, remember to complete the line, 1, 2, 3, complete the edge. Make sure you draw the edge and until the vertex here, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, let me check, 1, 4, 3, 4, 1, 4, 4, 3, okay, 1, 4, 4, 3, correct. So this is one of the answers. So you might be getting different answer. If you do it, maybe the way you do it, you reduce it different from mine, you might be able to get different answer. Okay, let me give you some other possible answers. So let's say if your answer is not this, it can be, okay, wait for a while, it can be like this as well. Okay, so if no vertex, I mean they do not give the vertex A, B, C, D. You just give, when you give a final answer, we just erase this. Okay, it just fits all. Okay, so let me give you another possible answer. It can be like this also. So this, okay, let me use red color to draw the edges. Okay, let me check, is this answer correct? The degree here is 1, okay, the degree here is 1, 2, 3. The degree here is 1, 2, 3, 4. The degree here is 1, 2, 3, 4, okay. 1, 4, 4, 3, 1, 4, 4, 3. Okay, this is another possible, another accepted answer. So these two answers are considered correct. Okay, so for this video, I just stop here first. So hope that you understand better about this part. And thanks a lot for spending time to watch my video. And thanks for your support. See you next time. Bye-bye.